That's Larry David. He created Seinfeld.
Oh.
Okay.
I'm a big man. I'm a big, expansive man.
I will body slam you so hard that you will poop your bald pants.
Larry? Larry David?
Larry!
Don't wanna be an American idiot.
Are you my Caucasian?
Oh, you official.
Huh?
Huh? We cool, Larry.
This is like, amazing.
Thank you!
Thank you!
Oh. Hey, Dad. You want a date with Mama?
I like it, man. I like it.
You're a disgrace to your people.
You need a good ass kicking.
My yarmulke almost fell off. I'm so taken aback.
What are you, sick?
I got a pubic hair stuck in my throat.
What's the matter with a big ass? I like big asses.
I think you should apologize.
Well, I was joking. The dog bit my penis.
You think this is funny, Larry?
Ha, ha, ha.
La, 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 la.
Feel totally natural.
There's something about this middle-aged bald guy that is thrilling.
I have a tendency to sort of drift towards catastrophe. I'm drawn to catastrophe like a magnet.
Should come up front.
Are you serious?
Yeah, why? What's the difference?
Larry, I'm not going to drive you around like I'm your chauffeur, get right?
Yeah, you're not driving me around like I'm a chauffeur with 2 minutes from the rehearsal hall.
What kind of person asks another person to drive him around like this? This kind of mentality is what's...
Whoa, what kind of person is so insecure that they have to make somebody move into the front seat so they don't think that they're driving somebody around?
It's my car. I make the rules, okay?
Oh, you can't drive with somebody in the back
seat. Yeah, you're such a baby. You're a grown man baby.
Are you saying I'm a man child?
Certain parts of that, Larry David, no doubt, is Larry David.
You know what? I'm not interested in your creative input about anything.
Well,
okay?
I'm sorry to tell you this, but I also gave notes on it.
Really? Well, I'm going to take those notes, and I'm going to shove them up my own ass.
A lot of it is not me.
Well, we were just in the neighborhood and thought we'd drop off your wedding gift. I'm sorry it's late. Congrats.
You can't take your wedding. Yeah. Are you serious?
No.
You can't take a wedding gift now.
No.
We got married 14 months ago. You can't give a gift after a year. You know that.
We've just spent $300 on this bottle of wine for you.
Sorry.
You're not accepting it? Is that what you're saying to me?
You can't take the gift after a year.
You had no problem taking the $200 engagement vase we got you. You had no problem with the shower gift. What'd you get her?
The nightgown.
The nightgown. That was okay. Then we flew to Chicago for your little wedding bash.
Little.
You know, you're into us now for about $5,500 as I see it.
First of all, it was not a little wedding. We had 266 people there.
Oh, sorry.
And then why did you come?
Why? Because she would have gun to my head, that's why!
Well, I have an entire imaginary world where I am married to Larry, and I imagine all the time that what if this wasn't just, you know, 10 seconds out of my life? What if this was my whole life? Every day was listening to him. We promise to continue loving each other unconditionally, not only throughout this lifetime, but after death, through all eternity.
This is continuing into the afterlife?
Yeah, that's the idea.
I thought this was over at death. I didn't know we went into eternity together. Isn't that what it said in Till Death Do Us Part? I thought it was...
Do you have a problem with eternity?
I thought I'd be single, I guess.
I'm sorry. I'm interrupting your single life in eternity?
So I guess I just took that for granted.
Okay. Do you not want to renew our vows because...
No, I want to renew our vows until, you know, I didn't... Can we take out the eternity part?
No.
Scrabble?
I love to play Scrabble.
I said it. I kind of got in the mood.
Let's get it.
Really? You want to play?
I'm all over it. Let's
go. Absolutely. Okay. You don't need to play. It's better with two.
Do you have any milk?
I think the real appeal of the show is me.
It's good to have a big friend. You can really smack him around, you know? Look at that. It doesn't hurt.
Don't feel a thing.
Susie's on her way up right now. Okay, a couple weeks ago, she went out of town. I made a phone call, like about 2 a.m. to a friend, woman, platonic. Okay, nothing going on. But she found the phone bill, and I told her it was you, okay? I said, you got in a fight with Cheryl, you slept over, and then you made the phone call, okay?
Wow, what a wild story.
I don't think it's that bad.
It's good.
It's pretty good.
I do think it's good.
Well, thank you. Good.
How come you didn't tell the truth?
Hey, 10 p.m. is the cutoff for platonic friends. After 10 p.m., it gets weird.
Hi,
hi.
Honey.
Hi.
Oh, Larry, I didn't know you were here.
I even forgot you were coming. What a surprise.
Hello. Hi.
So this is your wife?
No. What? No. No.
What kind of response is
no,
that?
No, that's my wife.
I see Susie Green as having justified anger. Larry and Jeff see her as just a complete nightmare. You're lying or you're lying. One of you two assholes is lying. I just don't know which one.
We're not lying.
The kid is home hysterical because her doll, Judy, has been decapitated. Because you two sickos took the head for God knows what reason. Where is it? Stop scratching your balls and tell me where it is. Get me the head!
Surrounded by his friends, he sits so silently and unaware of anything.
I can't shake this George thing.
Hello? Hello?
You are the guy who created Seinfeld.
What is wrong with you?
This guy's a disaster. He's a living disaster. He's a storm.
Are you trying to get an NAACP Image Award or something?
Your suggestion, Mr. Constructive Criticism.
You know why this is a nightmare?
What?
You will fail.
Larry!
Yeah, he vouched for you. You're all right.
You just swallowed our Lord and Savior.
Get your ass in here. Don't even look back.
And the Golden Globe goes to... Curb Your Enthusiasm.
This is a sad day for the Golden Globes. It is, however, quite a good day for Larry David. I suspect the wife will be a little forthcoming tonight. Of course, I'd like to thank my parents, who always taught me that when you have the opportunity to annoy someone, you should do so.
I'm looking for me. You're looking for you. We're looking at each other and we don't know what to do. They call me the seeker. I've been searching low and high.
I'm back.
I look to things better than ever.
I won't get to get what I'm after.